Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair?
Yeah, pretty much. That's anyway, normal, though.
When you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more.
Oh, I'm not a douche, don't worry.
Good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky.
Oh, jerky.
My sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't eat wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
I know people like that. It's kind of awful. Alright, keep going north.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette. And for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here. I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years. And, for some reason, I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
You know, you really can't run away from your problems, and I don't really understand why you had a problem. Like, it wasn't like it was any... Well, I sort of get it, but why did you... I don't know, I think you got a lot of problems that I'm not really meant for. Okay, good, it makes sure.
Alright, I got everything
got
I need
stuff.
Over here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
A jerk? God. I took all of them. No, I didn't.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah.
Neat.
Really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And... she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them.
Are you drunk?
But why don't you do the honors?
Maybe we call it the Flapjack Fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack Fire it is. They'll probably ask me if it was a camp cooking accident or something. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
I've had one too many bad experiences with tequila. I'm a little reticent to try it again.
Henry, we're adding some maybe big new words with you. Jeez.
Good experience with it.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
Hi, Bucket.
I'm glad you're here.
Sure you are.
I am.
I don't know what that means.
It doesn't matter. I get it. With Julie and everything, you probably don't want to be here.
Biff.
I don't know if that's true.
Forget I said anything. I just meant I like that you're here. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away?
I feel like I'm gonna go to sleep. Fire's hot and depressing. I just kinda wanna sleep.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Oh, great, thanks.
That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Makes sense. Is problem a euphemism?
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
It's the campfire from a while ago that I don't think should still be there. Huh. So, can I, like, hit on the... I don't really want to, because, you know, I'm pretty happy with my wife. But apparently there's just an option to hit on Delilah? That's a little weird. The fuck?
What the... Dee, I found a clipboard down here and I... There's something strange going on.
At the lake? What's up?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Why did I hear, like, a Henry, fucking computer noise?
I'm worried.
Hang on.
You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also...
Happy 4th of July, fireworks all night. Would it kill Paul McCartney?
Regardless, just Jimmy let me know. Hendrix. Okay, Buckaroo?
Absolutely.
Oh, God. I don't
me too, me three. What's your favorite music? Inaudible, relocate. So there's somebody listening. Huh. I'm gonna put this away. Kinda wanna get my fishing rod out. I don't really care about any of this. But I feel
I found a walkie-talkie out here too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck?
Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
What the fuck?
You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. We should just get the hell out of here.
Oh, it's a 10-day hike. You're welcome to do it, but you're gonna catch hell from the service and have to explain yourself.
Plus, done.
There's a
easy.
Fire burning across Rose Creek. You hiked through there on the way in.
Call someone and tell them to come get me.
I am not going to book a $15,000 helicopter ride for you. I'm not doing it.
Oh my God.
We can't freak out. There's got to be a reasonable explanation for all of this.
You're right. I'll head to Wapiti Meadow, but I swear, if this gets worse, you better get on the horn and get us out of here.
I'll call around and see if anything weird is happening to anyone else, okay?
Sounds good.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Huh. Alright. Okay, we can do this. We can figure out what's going on, and we're not going to have any issues whatsoever, and everything's going to be absolutely fantastic.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
What the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Hello, I'd imagine.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
If you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in 2 shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
South, around, down that way. I gotta go around for those two. All right. Okay. So this is getting really fucking weird and really, really kind of creepy. Like. Okay. Let's be an optimist here. Let's assume that... Let's assume that they're scientists. And they've just got some big thing going on, because it doesn't fucking matter if they tell her, because she just works there or whatever. Who cares? Who cares that she, if Delilah knows anything? She's just some lookout. Or whatever. Who cares? Okay. So, they're scientists, they work there, whatever. And they have their radios to talk to one another. And one of them accidentally gets in our line. You know, they're fucking scientists. They're bored. They fucking start writing down shit that we're doing. They're scientists. Scientists write down shit. That's all scientists do half the time. So they write down stuff. They write down our conversations. They add their little notes. It's like they wish they'd bring back Jimi Hendrix from the dead. Good. 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 That's alright. Forward. Up. That way. And then down. Alright. And that's entirely okay. It's a little weird, but whatever. 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 It's not like it matters. It's not like it matters. Our privacy is being invaded. And, everything.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Well, that's good.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
That sounds like a good idea.
Would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
The bruise on the back of my head should be doing something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
Alright, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Okay. But here's the thing. You don't have to sound crazy. You just report what I'm reporting to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground. Kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I mean, that's kind of how they're listening to us, probably.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I don't even know how you do that. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, Bob.
Do I have a sunburn on my knees? I have, like, a sunburn on my knees. That's great. What do you mean how you would do that? You fucking fiddle with the dial until you're getting the fucking signal from our radios. Like, any idiot could do that. It's how walkie-talkies work. You fiddle with the dial, you pick the thing, and you start yakking at one another. I can only assume our radios are fucking cheap because they're government. So, God knows they probably got them at Radio Shack for $7 a piece. In bulk. Off-brand.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
How do I get down there? Do I just... There's gotta be, like, a thing, isn't there? Oh, yeah, there is just a thing. Okay, yeah. This isn't that bad. Oh, boy. I don't want to jump to conclusions, but at the same time, things aren't looking too great. They're looking kind of weird. And I'm not a big fan of being listened to. Privacy is a big thing. I feel like I have the right to have mine. I don't need people fucking hearing about my wife. Copy that. That'll give us the things we need. Ron! Really wish the powers to be could issue us radios then suck ass. Most of the time I prefer to keep things pen and paper, but every once in a while it'd be nice to get a hold of you right away. My sister keeps leaving me messages at the main office, but I don't think she gets that I took the job, so I wouldn't have to deal with her or Mom. I've been sitting at the spot for a while now, thinking about what to say to her, but I'm a quarter of the way through a bottle of Fife instead. Miss you. Dave. Wow, there's a lot of books here. I kind of want to take them with me. But I can't. Grenada! Splash. One chance to die. The first book in the Crime by the Numbers. In Crime by the Numbers. From the author of the best-selling Spectrum spy series. One Chance to Die is the book that started it all. Nahal Black is South City's most effective but least known detective. That rhymed. Cool. I like this. Whoa.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks, now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see.
Yeah, pretty much.
The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Makes sense.
Are you serious?
Oh, come on, that one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Neat. Hey, I found a big tree. I can't report this at all. Alrighty then, I guess. Whatever's good then. I can't report it. It doesn't happen. Alright, I'm almost up to the last cache that I need. I think that's the... Wait, is that like the last... Wait, no, I can go right there. I'm in Wapiti Meadow. Over here, maybe. Huh. There's a lot left of this. A little worried I was almost done. Jeez. Supply cache! 1, 2, 3, and 4. Get that stuff, we can get it going, baby! Copy map information. Alright, what do we got here? Alright, so now there's a way back through that way. This one's chewed up. When the informants wind up dead, you call him Neil. Oh, Neil Black! I like Nahal Black better. Music in this is just heavy right now. I love it. Like, this is atmospheric. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if bad stuff's happening. I don't know if weird stuff's happening. There's that fucking tree. I have no idea why there's just a ski on. I wish I could report this. I have no clue what that's about, and I feel like I should. Unless it's like a ski tree or something. Is that like a dev thing? That's gotta be like a dev joke. I don't know how to react to that. Like, really. There's just... After playing, After playing Life is Strange, I know how to take a good picture now.
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Ooh.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
I don't like any of this. This is kind of... Alright. I should save some of those.
There's
I don't know what else we can find
out here. Not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah. I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den. Or, you know, anywhere.
I agree. Almost to the fire. We're almost to the camp and the firefighters and shit. I kind of just want to get the hell out of here. This is sort of terrifying as shit.
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the Scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware Weebelos in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers.
I beware of anything called a Weebelo.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
There's gotta be somewhere I can jump. Come on, Henry, we can make this. We actually can make this. Oh, it's just a fall. Alright. I thought that was a jump. Hey, a tree. A conspicuous tree. With axe marks. I feel like I'm getting an axe. Do I get to fight stuff now?
You ever talked to any of the Scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say.
This fire kind of fresh.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
Whoa, did I just, like, break?
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, a marching band?
Oh, no. Like, comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Hell yeah.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragons armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good. We're good.
I think my girlfriend can do that.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
Is it wrong? It's not wrong. I'm gonna take this and put these somewhere more useful. Because this does not seem to be used. I wanna step on the bear trap. Here? These are some really, like... Like, I know they're supposed to... What the fuck? I know they're supposed to be, scouts, but I think just leaving them in that is a bit, like, rude.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up. Hey, D, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
In the next few days, you and your team will be dropping into the thoroughfare, region of Shoshone National Forest, cut a fire line south of Ruby River, bringing you on behalf of Dr. Ben Simmons at Wapiti Station. He reached out to the superintendent with wildlife concerns about his research site. Upon your return, someone from his office wants to speak with you as part of the wildlife risk assessment of the region. I told them they have nothing to worry about, and your team's fire lines are the most potent preventive measures in protecting their site, even though they'll be more than a mile away, but I think they've got insurance companies to answer to. Thank you, as always, for your service, Rich Slosaranko.
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Oh, it is just... I was right!
...our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
I don't know, deer or some shit?
Oh, you know, probably just horned toads.
Maybe your turtle was an escapee.
Shit! And not Bucket Jr.!
Our conversations on it is just, what, recreation for them?
I'm just messing around. Somebody is obviously up to something. I'm freaking out here.
Hey!
I think that we should consider
that, was loud.
Maybe this is all just a coincidence, but my gut says that there is something bad going on.
Mine too. Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
This shouldn't take long. I know the quickest way back.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Yeah?
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
When?
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
I'm in an open field.
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh,
holy shit.
There isn't any way someone, like another lookout, could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
I feel like that's wrong.
Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Oh, shit. I didn't even get a chance to use my axe. This is serious. And kind of terrifying. Oh, my knees are fucking burned.
This is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The Flapjack Fire continues to move in a southerly fashion.
Yeah.
Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
You can do me for a trip out of here. I don't care if it's on horseback or a helicopter or in a canoe. Just get me out of here.
Henry, we have work left
Bucket
to do.
Bucket Jr., okay.
Let's chat about what's bothering you and you'll feel better.
Bucket Jr.
Are you serious?
My clear place.
Let's talk. Okay?
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
Yeah.
It's just protocol that those stay
this
up.
Thing.
You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Cottonwood Creek. Cottonwood Creek. Alright. Okay. We're going to Cottonwood Creek. And we're gonna figure out what's going on here.